Hello everybody, my name is Trevor Selescu and I'm the owner of Monster Hobbies in High River, Alberta, Canada. Welcome to a slightly different video. This is a slot car tune-up video and I'm going to show you how to tune and maintain your cars for better speed and performance. So here's some cars I just finished tuning up. This one is mine, these two are Fred's, and this one is Roger's. So I'm going to take Fred's car here and show you exactly how I tuned it up. I have Fred's number 98 Ford Torino here, which we're going to take apart and take a look at. So before we do that, we're going to see how this car actually performs right out of the box on our track. So let's go down and have a look at that. Okay, so we have a section of our track here. I don't know how much of this you're actually going to see, but let's start up Fred's car here. Okay. Now, it looks to drive okay, but I don't know if you can hear a little wump 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 as it drives through. Anyway, see, at higher speeds it tends to want to break away a little bit. Yeah, try it on the outer rail here. Well, all in all, it's not too bad, but let's take a look at inside and see what's going on. Okay, so I got this white piece of paper so you can see. So what we're going to do, first off, the brushes, the brushes here are pretty tight. To get a little better contact on those corners and that, it's always best to fan them out a little bit. But anyway, so what we'll do is we'll take the screws out of this. I'll show you the first part of tuning a car here for better performance. Now, one of the major things is, I don't care what track you are, how clean you keep these things, there's always some hair and stuff that can get into your wheels. And especially here, you can see those little dots. That's actual grass from our grass mat. If your car comes up off of there, you can actually kick dust into from the wheels into the car body. So here's our basic Carrera type chassis for these slot cars. There's our positive negative from the pickups, the wire coming into the digital chip here. These are the newer chips inside this one. But as you can see, it goes in, provides power here. Those two little ones are for head and tail lamps, which we don't have, as well as this. And then there's a gray wire comes off, goes into your motor. Now this is one of the things people don't really realize. If you take the tires off all the way around, this is step one. Machining your wheels. So we take the tires off, and I'll bring this up to the camera lens. You see here, that little black dot, that's, and there's one over here. Those are actual areas where they've cut this wheel off of the plastic sprue. If you know your plastic models, you know there's like a tree and all the parts are attached to the tree. On these wheels, you'll see 1, 2, 3, and 4 places where they've actually attached these from the sprue and clipped them off. This one's fairly smooth, but if you feel, you can feel a bump in there. And there's also, if you can see it, a seam line right here where my thumbnail is that goes right around the wheel. And it's the same on the fronts. Now, like I say, this one's pretty smooth. You might be able to get away with it. But on some of the other cars, these bumps are really rough in here. And they'll actually cause your tire on the track to bounce up and down like this each time it hits. And you're going really fast, so you're getting this kind of thing, maybe even faster than that, as your car goes around the track. So I'll show you how to get rid of those. Okay, here's the way to get rid of that on the back wheels. Now, if you notice, without the tires, you know, you can gun this and the car's not going to go anywhere. Now, Carrera doesn't recommend you doing this, however. Carrera's not here. No, I'm just kidding. So I've got this block of MDF wood. It's a little offcut, and I've wrapped 180 grit sandpaper around it. This is a sticky back sandpaper. It's used in auto body collision repair. It's actually on a circular DA sander. But what you can do here is hold the block down on the top of the wheels, making sure you're nice and flat, even to the wheel. As you can see, a lot of dust got removed. However, if you... whoops. Okay, come on, camera. Focus. Oh, I know why. Okay. Now, if you look at that wheel, you'll see that we're starting to machine it perfectly flat. Now, this will remove the bumps as well as level down that seam line. We got to go a little further. Basically, the good thing is the wheel is painted, as you can see, painted silver. And the plastic is actually darker. So we'll just do this again real quick. In fact, I'm gonna come down here. I'm probably blocking the view of the camera, just so I can see that I'm holding this on here flat. Whew. They use ABS plastic on these. You can smell it. Anyway, okay, so there is your perfectly machined wheel. And yeah, you'll notice now it's 100% perfectly round. Now what you can do, because 180 grit leaves like some sand scratches in there, so if you want, this is a block with a lighter grade sandpaper. There. Now that'll smooth out some of those sand scratches. But the thing is, the sand scratches don't really matter. Because, as long as this area here at the top of the wheels is flat, where my fingers are rubbing, your tire will seat 100% perfectly there. Now the front wheels don't have the benefit of being motorized. So I've got this little flat file, and what I'll do is go on top of the actual spots where it came off the tree and carefully file those down with the file here. Now we still got that seam line in there. Front wheels, it's not 100% mandatory to get it perfect, but it does help to get as best as you can. I think that's the first one I did. So then we go to the other side here. Be careful where you put your finger on that digital chip. Don't want to break something off.
So just file these bumps out of here. Now, what you can do, if you want these wheels a little better, is just put your sanding block, see what I mean by keeping that flat? And, or you could do it this way. What you want to do is rotate the wheels so that the sanding block can do its thing. This is a bit trickier. Here we go. My dad always said, hold these things so you can see them. So here we go. See how that's slowly sanding that down? You know, eventually with a bit of work, you can get that fairly decent. Okay, I'm going to do this side, turn the camera off, and come back. Okay, so I got... Oh, that's back wheels. I got the front wheels pretty decent just by rolling that the wheels with the sandpaper up there. Still a little bit of a seam line, but it shouldn't make too much of a difference. Now, one thing I like to do is... carefully... pop the wheels up here. Yeah. There we go. Pop the wheels up and remove that axle. Now, sometimes, I don't know if you can see this, but if you take the bushing and slide it back, sometimes hair will actually get caught right up into here. Now there isn't really much going on this one. I don't know if you guys can see it. This side's got maybe a bit. Yep, it's got some on there. Just always try this maintenance every time you race. Try to get that hair out from there because it will get caught up into those brass bushings and cause your wheels to go a little slower, which causes your engine to struggle more. And of course you put wear on your engine as well as losing speed. So I'm going to show you another little trick here. Just bear with me. Okay, so I got a little rag here. I'm just going to wipe this area here. And on the other side of the gear, just to get the oil and stuff off, the grease, whatever's going on there. Okay, remember this little fine sanding block? If you can do it. Oops. Try to remember how we did the wheels here. Try to do the same thing here on the axle where that bushing is. Where the bushing's going to be, because here, in case there is it, it's hard to really tell, but if there's any little barbs or anything on the axle, this will machine it as well. Let's see something. Here we go. Fold this in half. Probably should get a new one. Fold it again. Okay, there we go. So just wrap that around, try to keep some pressure behind it. So you're actually sanding it, and now we're going to machine this axle with the sandpaper. And we'll go do that on this side. Just on those edges there. Now you can take your rag, wipe any dust off. Now you're going to have a little less drag on your bushings right at that point. So, another thing I like to do here, once I bend my viewfinder back, if you take your wheels off and you rub your finger across there, you'll feel a seam line. Nice one right in here. This seam line goes all the way around the body. It's in the mold process when they make the model. So what I like to do is scrape these seam lines down in case this is a flash. They call flash. It's when your seam line starts to squish over and actually make a ridge. So you want to take and use your hobby knife and scrape that down, pardon me, until you really can't feel it. It should feel round. It's a technique on its own. You might have to look for it on YouTube or something. They call this adzing when you drag your knife across plastic like this. But you take the seam line off, you make it nice and smooth. You want to chase the seam line all the way around your car. Just eliminates any problems from anything not fitting together properly. If you want to go on a funny level, you're actually shaving off just a slight bit of weight as well. I don't know if a milliounce is going to make a difference in this, but this is allowed in our league, by the way, since I'm showing you guys the videos of what is allowed and what isn't allowed. Rewinding your engine wires and all that kind of crazy stuff. No, we don't really allow for that. Drilling holes in your undercarriage, you know, to lighten it up and all that other stuff. That's not allowed, because what I want to try to do is get this as close to off the shelf as possible to make it fair for the other guys that maybe don't know these techniques. You know, we don't need like super duper, we're not racing for $1 billion here, you know, kind of thing. This is a fun night, so don't want the fun to be to trounce somebody by doing all kinds of these bizarre, you know, speed secrets, but just to get the basic, you know, something that's fair across the board. And finally right there. And now that's done there. Don't want to lay my knife across the track. Now we got the front wheels off. So we can actually, because we don't have to get around the gear. Should try to get a new piece. Put that around this block. This block I made from an old sandal. It's like where you put your foot. Just cut it with a bandsaw. Scary as hell, but you know. So look at that, you can actually fit this block right there. And again, do that same thing. Deburring the axle, which again is machining it. Just in case, remember to wipe the oil off of here if there's any, before you get your sandpaper all oily. This is actually wet, dry sandpaper, which means you can use water on it too, which cleans the cutting surface. There. Now this should free up a little bit of room in the bearings. Again, the fat of my fingers are not doing this, so So what we'll do is we'll walk this under the wire. Slide the bushings back in place. Mind the wire, like they said in the original All's Quiet on the Western Front. Mind the wire! Mind the wire! Okay. Pop this back into place. Now that should spin better. And we'll get that rear axle on there too. Now remember to keep in mind which way the axle goes. Sometimes they'll actually have a groove right there. Okay, so we kind of rotate this a little bit. Get these bushings in the right place. Sorry, I might be all over the place, just trying to use my fingers to get this in. Okay, I'm going to pop this off camera. I'll be right back. Okay, so now we'll do the second step. I put the rear tires on here just to make sure I got this in the right side. If I don't, when I push the trigger, the car will go backwards. If I got it right, it'll go forward. So here we go. Okay, so I got that in the right direction because there wasn't really a groove there for that. So now let's see what the second part of this is. Now there's one good thing about the Carrera NASCARs is the front and rear tires are the same tire. So you can actually machine your tires. So just as the same way we did with the wheels, we'll do with the tires. So you just rock the car back and forth here on the sanding block. Trying to keep it as flat as you can. They like to fight because there's so much resistance. Okay. Stop torturing the motor. So now you can see what we've done. Whoops. Is we've machined this tire surface down so that just like our wheels here, it will be 100% square. Scraped a little bit on the magnet there. Anyway, so that's it, that technique. Now the nice thing, like I said, you can take these and throw them up to the fronts now. And then, oops, let's set this camera back a little. Get the full body effect. So now we got this to there. And now we can do our back wheels here. Remember to keep your decent decade thing out to the front. So I got this oil. This is sewing machine oil. There's better stuff on the market, I know. Actually, I sell some in the store. But this will be good for now. So on the back hub of the motor, just put a little drop there. You want to manipulate this to move her into the motor. Then put a little drop on your axle, let it seep into the bushing. Same here. And then in the front, one there. And one there. Did that go in? That one Now you can see here, watch. 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, 4 Mississippi. Well, 4 seconds of spin. And here, we'll just work that oil into there. You can also push on the motor, make sure it's all seated. There already is sounding way better. So what I'll do is I'll screw the body on and we'll take a look at how this goes around the track now.
Okay, now here's another technique just before we start racing. If you look at the wheels, they will get dirty. Okay. Here, just bend these brushes out a little. What I found is, if you take a pink pearl eraser and you hold it to your tire, the same way we did with the sandpaper and all that, and you go across, this little eraser will actually knock all that stuff off. And if you can see, it'll actually take any gummy rubber off too. Well, rubber debris, I guess I'll say. Yeah. This will help in your grip. So blow off the excess rubber. You can do this periodically throughout the race when you're not racing on the track. Because remember, we got 13 guys in our slot car league now because we got another guy joined in. So there's 2 heats, 5 minutes long. So when the 5 minutes are going, you just sit there with your eraser doing this. Another thing you can do is spin the wheels, look at the tires, check to make sure the rotation is perfect, not having a tire going like this. Because if it is, you'll have to see if it's not seating on the rim. But all this looks really good. Same with up front. A little bit of a wob, wob, wob going on there. Rotate your tire maybe a little. Sometimes when Carrera's putting these on, they'll just slap the wheels on real tight and they might be a little off. Okay, so there it is, sitting on the track, ready to go. And I'll just zoom out and we'll check out how this goes here. Okay, here comes Fred's car. See, now it's driving really smooth. So now that it's driving smoother, we can actually, I should have put my guardrails on here. We can actually increase the speed. And it won't tend to go off. Okay, let's get some new camera angles. Okay. The nice thing is, you get more speed out of this car. Here. Better handling. There we go. Oh, almost reslotted back there. Well, anyway, you guys get the idea how this all works, so that is the car now retuned, and we'll see how it goes on the next night when we do Daytona. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video on tuning up your slot cars. When you're in Monster Hobbies, come by the window here and check out all our extra parts. We've got like spare tires. These are all Carrera parts, spare parts. Tires for your NASCAR. And these are the rear axles. These are older Dodge ones, but they should work under those Fords. And then of course we've got like the vintage big wheels, all kinds of other things, even some of the old monogram Tiger brushes and whatnot. And some SCX wheels, very vintage. So come on down, check them out, and we'll see you in the future. Thanks for watching. Bye.